friends. Today's story is about a research which was done in a very rare and weird way. Today it is very simple for us to answer how the food travels in our body after lunch or dinner. So let's listen the story of those people who made it simple for us to understand the journey of the food in our body. The name of the story is Martin and Dr. Bowman. It is written by Nivedita Kulkarni, read by Manasi Kokit, video editing by Amiya Kulkarni. This is the creation of Manthan Learning Resources. This is not an imaginary story. It is a true one which had taken place around 200 years ago in 1822. It was the period when things like electric bulbs or photo films were invented, when India was ruled by British. This is the story of a duo who discovered the process that is happening daily inside our body. When one eats food, how did the food get digested? Today, if I'll ask this question, I'm sure you will answer it quickly and easily. But before this story, which we are going to listen today, people were totally unaware how the food travels further after eating and what happens to it later. A doctor discovered this with a very less resources available to him. The surprising thing is that it all happened because of a man who met with an accident. Let's listen exactly what happened and how did it take place. The story took place at Mackinac Island, Michigan in Indiana, United States. It is located in northeastern part of America. Martin Alexis was a very handsome 19 years old man working as a boatman for a company that traded animal skins in that area. Martin was killed at work. One day, as usual, Martin was working on the boat. The boat was at the shore and suddenly there was a loud banging of a gun. Some people used guns here to hunt ducks in the pond. But this time, Martin's co-workers noticed that something strange had happened along with the sound of the gunfire. This time, the hunter's bullet did not hit a duck, but actually it hit Martin. Martin was shot in the abdomen and fell on the ground. Actually, it was an accident. No one intended to kill Martin, but the accident happened because the target was missed while hunting ducks. Martin was seriously injured in the shooting. There was a panic situation on the boat. Urgent treatment was needed and an army doctor was posted in that area. His name was Dr. William Bowman. He was called for the treatment. Till that time, lot of bleeding had happened. Dr. Bowman began first aid, but Martin's condition was serious. No one thought Martin would survive. Even Dr. Bowman himself did not see any chance of survival. The bullet had made a large hole inside the abdomen, just below the ribs. Martin was taken to an army camp in that condition. It was June 6, 1822. Both treatment methods and tools were not much developed at that time. But after several attempts, Martin survived. Dr. Bowman saved him. Bowman had to try for 7 to 8 months in a row for that. Gradually, Martin's wounds began to heal. But while it was healing, a rare and strange thing happened. A sign of an accident remained on that part of the body. By the time the bullet passed through the skin, it had cut inside the abdomen as well. While the wound was healing, the hole in the abdominal bag and the hole in the outer skin matched, but it didn't fill up the hole from inside. And so, from the outside, a direct passage was created up to the abdominal bag. Such a rare formation is called as permanent gastric fistula. A fistula is an abnormal combination of two hollow parts. This type of match can usually occur during surgery. It's not a surgical defect, but an occasional reaction from the patient's body. Martin's hole was never completely healed. After this difficult surgery, Martin survived, but he became quite weak. He was no longer able to work in his company, so Bowman hired him to work under him. Bowman had, in fact, another motive for doing so. Bowman was a researcher, basically. He saw an opportunity while treating Martin, a very rare opportunity, a chance to peep into Martin's belly bag. How could that be possible? Because of that wonderful hole in Martin's body. It had a very thin skin, like a curtain on the hole. At first, when the wounds began to heal, the food Martin was given was often indigestible for him, and then it came out through vomiting. But sometimes it came out of the hole instead of the mouth. When it came out, the membrane, that means that skin peel, would stabilize on the hole again. In medical terms, this is called a valve. Valves are devices that are used to control the flow of fluid. Until then, no one knew exactly what happens to food inside the body. This was a rare opportunity for Bowman to find that out. This was an opportunity to understand the process of digestion of food. When the wound was completely dry, Bowman began to do some experiments. He used to tie food to one end of a thin rope and slide it through this hole of Martin. It was taken out again after a few hours. The changes in the extracted food were recorded by Bowman. Changes in color, changes in smell, changes in the texture of the food, everything was recorded. Taking different foods and studying the processes that take place inside it at different times, everything was recorded. Bowman discovered that some of the acidic fluid in the stomach sac causes a process called digestion, and what is not digested here is passed out of the bag. This is how Bowman first learned the process of digestion. In 1825, he published his scholarly observations in a journal. The process of digestion in the human body was coming in front of the world for the first time. Bowman didn't stop after that. His curiosity and inquisitiveness and Martin's tolerant and restrained nature revealed many secrets of the digestion. Bowman performed nearly 200 different experiments on Martin's body in 10 years, and from those observations, he drew almost 51 different conclusions. Here are some of his conclusions. The abdominal sac moves in a specific way. This movement helps in the process of digestion of food and also pushes the food further. Solid food does not remain solid when it enters the stomach bag. It is converted into semi-solid matter. This conversion is caused by acid that get formed in the stomach sac. This is the process of digestion. He also found out that when we bite food, small pieces of food are made and the saliva in the mouth is mixed with it, and a soft, moist ball of food is formed, which is easy to swallow. The esophagus is attached to the throat, which carries the swallowed food into the stomach bag. A type of acid is formed in large quantities in the stomach bag. It is the hydrochloric acid. This acid processes the soft, moist food and makes the food liquid. The small intestine is attached to the stomach bag. This liquid food goes further into the small intestine. In the small intestine, those essential nutrients are removed from the liquid food, and then the unwanted components are sent to the large intestine, which is connected to the small one. In the large intestine, the water is absorbed, and then the solid waste products are pushed out, which are then further expelled from the body. This long journey of food takes long time, and that is why when Dr. Bowman fed Martin constantly, he couldn't digest the food properly. It does happen to us too, doesn't it? Do we give enough time to digest food properly? We should check it once, right? Bowman's experiments revealed this important journey of food into the human body. Many of his experiments were on the processing of food in the stomach bag. The journey took place as the food passed through the stomach bag was largely a prediction by the Bowman. But this prediction helped many scientists to further understand the precise process of digestion. Bowman had some more interesting findings also. One of it is raw food takes more time to digest than the cooked food. Or he also found out that during digestion, milk coagulates the fastest of all liquids, of course, except water, which means that the process of accumulation of solids is faster in the milk. Bowman published his findings in the medical journal in January 1826. The article in this journal were noticed in many parts of the world. While all this was going on, Martin got tired of this constant experiments and he just ran away. Bowman was very upset. While the research was in full swing, the medium of his research disappeared. But with many efforts, he contacted several places to find out Martin. Martin was found in 1829. When he was found, Bowman explained everything to Martin. He convinced him about the importance of the wonderful things that the world is knowing just because of both of them. Eventually, Martin agreed to stay with Bowman once again. In just 2 years, that is from 1829 to 1831, Bowman performed 56 more experiments. In 1831, Bowman experimented with digestion in a different manner. Effects of changes in air temperature on digestion, or effects of changing body temperature on digestion, or the difference in the time it takes to digest different types of food, and even how the intensity of human emotions affect digestion, and also the change in the intensity of human emotions due to not getting food at right time. All these experiments were done by Bowman. All this research has given the world a lot of information about digestion. In 1833, he wrote a book on the results of all these experiments. Experiments and observations of digestive juice and the physiology of digestion. In 1833, Bowman and Martin separated. After retiring from the army, Bowman moved to St. Louis, where he started his own clinic, and Martin returned to Quebec City in Canada. Dr. Bowman died in a minor accident in 1853 at the age of 68. But the weak Martin, who had a wonderful sign of a major accident, lived a healthy life of 85 years and died in 1880. These two individuals helped the world to understand some of the basics of human digestion system that led to further research to scientists.